Hello and welcome to another episode of my Working with Todoist series. My name is Carl Pullein and this week it's all about sorting your lists. So what do I mean by sorting your list? Well, this week Todoist have launched a new feature called Sort. And essentially what that means is you now have almost complete freedom to show the lists in the order that you want to see them. So of course we've got date order, and in the past what we've done is we've created elaborate filters to create the kind of lists that we want to see. Well, Todoist has given you that feature now in a sort order, and it is across the board. So it doesn't matter whether you're using the free version of Todoist or you're using the premium version. I can't actually believe that, because this is a game-changing new feature. Boards was great. Boards with sort, as you will soon find out, is incredible, and you're going to love that new feature. Now, I've put together a video to show you how I use it, or how I will be using it using the time sector system, but if you're more into the old-fashioned way of having all your projects in your menus, setting up projects, then Todoist have also done a video, which I will link to below, which will show you how to use the new sort features with assigning tasks to family members or colleagues. So it's just a fantastic new feature. Okay, before we go any further, I would just like to say, if you do get any value from this video, then please help me by clicking on that like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet and you would like to get all the latest tips, tricks and news on using Todoist, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, let me take you into my Todoist demo account and I will show you almost everything you need to know about sort. Okay, so what are we talking about by sort options? Well, if you've updated your Todoist to the very, very latest version, you will now see that you have these little arrows here. Now, at the moment, I'm in my today view, and I automatically, as you know, your today view will always prioritize your tasks by priority first. So we've got P1, P2, P3, and then P4 down at the bottom. But let's say that that's not how you want to look at your list, your today list today. So what you can do is you can go into the sort options here and just click on that. And you can sort by due date, which is a bit silly in today because everything in here is going to be due today. You can sort by priority, which it automatically does anyway. You can sort by alphabet, so I can click on that and it will sort things out alphabetically. Now, that list, I've not been able to figure out how I would ever use that one, but there you go, maybe there is a way. Maybe you want to use it by alphabetically, and so you've got this here. Now you can change, so you can either click back on here and you can get those sort options, or you can click on here, which would reset everything back to the way it was before, or quickly go back to that, and now you can do a what's called a custom sort. So I can group things together. So I'm going to group things by priority, and I'm going to sort by I'm going to sort by default. It doesn't really matter to me. So I'm going to sort by default and assign to anyone while I don't assign anything. So I'm going to click that. What it does now is it separates out my priorities. So I've got priority 1, priority 2, priority 3. So this is a great way now. I mean, there's a filter that I use, which I don't actually have here at the moment, but I have a filter which does this, but I don't actually need that filter anymore, because now in one view, I can go through the way that I manage my tasks. So I always start by looking at my priorities for the day. So priority 1 is to exercise and to write my podcast script. Those are my two objectives for today. I can then move into my morning task, because I use P2 as my morning tasks, and then I can move into my P3, which is my afternoon task, and then whatever's left is basically just my routines. So that's way that you can manage your today view. But what about if you're going to go into your project view? Now, I don't use projects in their typical order, and I'm going to change this because you're seeing as I've been playing with this, I'm going to remove the sorting. So I'm going to go into my this week folder. Now, if you're using the time sector system, this is the folder that you get. You've got this week's task right up at the top here, and then you've got your recurring areas of focus underneath, and you can close those out. So what do you want to do? Now, when I'm doing a planning session, this is the sort options are going to come in really useful, because here's a really cool trick. You can go into sort and let's go to custom sort. I'm going to group these tasks by, let's say, by priority. And I'm just going to sort by default. So I'm going to sort that. So again, I've got my priorities sorted there. Now, here's another one. Let's go back into the custom sort. Let's group this by due date. Now, remember, this is my this week folder. So if you're using the time sector system, your this week folder will have dates. So sort by, it doesn't really matter here. I can do this by, so I'm grouping by due date. I'm going to sort by priority. So that means the priority levels are going to stay the same. It's going to be P1 at the top, by 2P3, and then let's go. So sort. Now, okay, so what I've got is I've got today and I've got tomorrow, but here's the really cool trick. Let's move into my view as board. Now, what I've done, because my custom sorting, actually, let's go back to the beginning here. If I remove the custom sorting and I'm going to by board, what I've got is I've got my no section here. That's because my this week is no section, but my recurring areas of focus is a section. But let's go back into my sort view here. So let's go back to the custom. I'm going to group the tasks by due date. I'm going to sort by priority. Now look what happens. It changes the board. So I'm just going to get rid of the menu. So let's just type M. So now I can see, now remember, this is this week. So if I was doing this on Monday, it would have Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. As I'm recording this on Friday, so I've only got 3 days, but it is actually showing me Monday over there. So now I can actually, when I'm doing my weekly planning session, when I finish my weekly planning session, I can actually go in here and I can see if I've loaded a day. So today is loaded, I've got too many tasks, but Sunday's looking quite quiet, Saturday's looking quite quiet. So, and Monday's looking dead. But this is just a wonderful way. Now, if you want to remove that, I can just click the plus, click there, and it will go back to its original view. Actually, I prefer my this week as a list, so I'm going to go back to list, and that goes back to the list. But that's one of the beauties of this sort function. Let's bring back the menu. Let's go into next week. So here's my task for next week. Now, this is my demo account, so I just add tasks randomly. I'm going to go into the sort order here. I'm going to sort, again, I'm going to sort by, let's have a play. We're going to group by date added. Okay, sort by, well, I don't have due dates in there, but let's just group by date added. So in here, everything was added on Tuesday, the 10th of November. So, but if you've got, if you're using this week, sometimes you're not pulling over your tasks on a regular basis. So let me just, let's just create a task in here. So this is a task. So you can just see this working. So this is a task, and we're gonna move that to my next week. So I'm gonna move that there and add the task. So that's gone in now, so cancel that. Let's go back into next week. So remember, I have got this sorting, and the sorting doesn't disappear until you click this cross. So I can go in here, and so that task was updated today, on Friday the 20th of November. Now the same thing would apply in your inbox. If you see, you've got your sorting options in your inbox. So again, let's go back into next week, because I know I've got a task here. So let's move this task to my inbox. So let's go there and move that to inbox. And let's move another one to inbox, because these ones, as you can see, we actually picked up these on Tuesday. So let's go into that. So let's go back into my inbox, and let's move this task here also to inbox, so that we've got, there we go. So we've moved those now. So we've got three tasks in my inbox. Now sometimes, and I've seen this with a lot of my coaching clients, what they've done is they've managed to have hundreds and hundreds of tasks in their inbox, but now they don't know when they were added or how old they are, anything like that. What you can do is go into your sort options. You can sort by due date, sort by priority. Let's go back down here to custom sort. You don't necessarily group by default, so you don't necessarily have, but date added, sort by date added. So what you'll see is these were added up at the top, and this was added Friday, this was added today. Let's change that now. So let's group by date added and sort by default, let's just say. Let's go in. So now you can actually reorganize your inbox to see when you are adding tasks. So you can start with the oldest one first. So this is just a fantastic way of being able to manage your the way that you see your task. So I've got one here. I don't actually have labels. So as you can see, this hasn't been upgraded yet. So I haven't upgraded this yet. Needs upgrading, which I will do. So my filters are not going to work and my labels are not going to work. It's expired. Oh dear, I need to change that. So, but what I will do is I will update that. But the beauty of this is it does work with your labels and it does work with your filters. And the beauty of it is this is a free part of Todoist. So you actually can now have a limited version of filters just by using the sort options. Now, there's so much more that you can do. And Todoist actually put out a fantastic video yesterday, which I'm going to link to below so you can actually go and see how Todoist has shown how this works, because there's a lot of things that this sort works. Like, I don't have any assignees. I don't have traditional old-fashioned projects in my Todoist. So if you want to see how it works with those, then you can watch that video and it's linked down below. So it just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Hello, thank you very much for watching my videos. Now I have something exciting to tell you about. Recently I have developed a brand new time management system. It's a system designed to manage your time in the 21st century. The world has changed a lot over the last 20 years. In fact, it's actually changed a lot this year. And what we need now is a system, a time management system that is very easy to use, easy to maintain, so that you can spend more of your time doing the work. And that's what the time sector system is all about. It's going to change your whole belief system about the way a time management system should work, because this focuses on when you are going to do the task. And let's be honest, it doesn't matter how motivated, inspired, or how urgent something is. If you don't have time to do it, it is never going to get done. And that's what this system is built around, getting your work done so you can spend more of your time doing the things that you want to do. I hope you join me in this course. The full details of the course are in the show notes below, so please join me, and thank you very much for watching this brief video.